right mood.
I see.
Go down.
A December 3?
That's your role.
That's your role.
Yeah.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you. I'm gonna ask someone how you're gonna climb.
Start the service, proceed Charlie to the church. I understand you'll be following Charlie. Yeah? There was some music needed to be playing. Do you have a music to... There's a music playing in already, so we'll go with the music which is in the church playing. Yeah? Okay. Thank you. Please start. videographer's chair. A very good morning to you all and welcome to St. Matthew. I'm so sorry for the loss of your loved one, Charlie. But it's so sad that you are here this time to celebrate his life, but also for his funeral. For those who like to use a toilet, we have toilets through those doors. You just pull them and you could use those signs to go to the toilet. The end of the service will learn itself, so I'm not going to, for those people who are reading or those who are talking, they'll just follow each other when that time comes. We welcome you to be with us, but let's use this time as it suits us, as we remember Charlie. It's unfortunate that myself, I've never met Charlie, but seeing your love, and hearing how many people are waiting, wanting to come to the service today, it makes my heart know that Charlie was well loved. Reading the stories and the eulogy, which is there because I read it yesterday, I could see Charlie was well loved. And hearing his journey from Ghana to here, all that, I could see who he was. I'll start with the Bible readings. I am the resurrection and the life, says the Lord. Those who believe in me, even though they die, will live. And everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. We brought nothing into the world, and we take nothing out. The Lord gave, and the Lord has taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Dear friends, as I've said, we meet in the name of Jesus Christ, who died and was raised to the glory of God the Father. Grace and mercy be with you. We have come here today to remember before God our brother, our dad, our uncle, our cousin, husband, Charles Afriyie or Charlie, to give thanks for his life, to commend him to God, our merciful Redeemer and Judge, and commit his body to be buried, and to comfort one another in our grief. Let us pray. Merciful Father, hear our prayers and comfort us. Renew our trust in your Son, whom you raised from the dead. Strengthen our faith that all who have died in the love of Christ
share in his resurrection, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. We're going to hear a few tributes, and we are going to start with Lovelette, the daughter. You have done marvelous. This lady, I have to say, she has been amazing, because I've been in contact with her, and she has been amazing, planning everything, discussing things, very difficult things with me, which I do respect you for that, and I've been praying for you. So it's your chance to bring your tribute. Thank you so much, thank you. That's so powerful. And I could say also the tribute that you gave, you know, and all the energy you put in planning this. It was incredible. Thank you. And we are going to hear from Kevin. Nephew, do you want to say anything, if you are able to?
One step enough. for me. For everything there is a season, and a time for every matter under heaven. A time to be born and a time to die. A time to plant and a time to unplant whatever is planted. Fellow monets, family and friends of our late friend, brother, uncle, father, and grandfather, Charles Kojona Afriyie. I stand here this morning in total shock and disbelief. We're full of sorrow following the sudden death of Charles last December. On behalf of all his numerous friends worldwide, such as those in Ghana, Germany, Italy, and the USA, and here especially in the United Kingdom, I'm paying this tribute to this fine, gifted man, inside and out, who was wonderful, a very wonderful friend to all of us, supporting us with his gentle and caring nature, a very generous and a level-headed person, ever ready to offer a helping hand in any situation. One of his beliefs in life was the importance of being authentic with people. Always say what needs to be said, because it's good for the relationship and for the soul. Personally, Charles and I were more than best friends. In actual fact, we were even more than brothers. Aside from growing up in a suburb of Kumasi as a teenager, both of us went for greener pastures in the mid-80s. I was there and Charles joined me. We had a good time together, visiting each other time and again. We went there, as you all know, for greener pastures. Today, we are all mourning this wonderful man. We never thought he would be taken away from us so early. But nobody can question that. He created Charles. He knows what he's doing. In times of this, words of comfort and songs will help us to go through. And as some of you present here aren't aware, I got my rightful and legal status in the UK residency with a full assistance and support and quick thinking of my good buddy, Charles. Today, as we all bid our final farewell to him, I say once again, a big thank you, my good friend, and we all salute you. In fact, we have really lost a great soul who has been a great and fortified person in our lives. It's been the most painful and difficult period for all of us since we heard of his shocking, unexpected early demise on the 21st December last year. And most especially, the fact that a lot of family and friends aren't here due to the restrictions of this terrible pandemic makes it even more sad. Charlie, you really fought a good fight on earth. You will be missed. Your absence has been felt, and it's being felt, and will forever be felt. We express our very heartfelt condolences to the love of your life, this young, your children, and your entire family, both at home and abroad. May the Almighty God give you an eternal rest till we meet again. Our good friend Charlie, rest in peace. Lead kindly light amid the circle gloom. Lead on me on. The night is dark and I am far from home. Lead on me on. Keep down my feet, I do not pass to see. One step, even for me. Thank you.
much appreciate everybody who has said anything, because that's very, very powerful. All who have talked, let's appreciate them for that talk. We're going to hear the music and then we move on to the Bible reading. So after the music, Michelle, you'll be leading for us the Bible reading.
I just want to say to the family and everybody, condolences, Alicia. You know, I love you. I love Uncle Charles. Uncle Charles was so good to me and my family. I'm just thinking back now when my mum passed away and I was dying and happy. Uncle Charles said to me, cheer up, cheer up. You know, your mum's spirit goes on and lives on. And I'm just sitting down and looking around in this room and I see all these kids that he's left behind in their faces. And then I can blow up Uncle Charles. I've had some good memories of Uncle Charles. I remember when I got my Ghanaian boyfriend and I was like, oh, I'm going to go to Ghana. And he was like, every year you say that and you're never going to go. I actually was supposed to go to Ghana in December last year, but that got cancelled due to COVID. And I used to say to him, oh, you know a Ghanaian word, chale? And he used to be like, no, it's chale. You know, he used to say, you need more execution behind it. So I'm going to read this hymn, and it's basically based off talking about that nothing can separate us from the love of God. And it's taken from Romans chapter 8, verse 3, 38 to 39. For I am persuaded that death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Jesus our Lord. Amen. Rest in peace, Uncle Charles.
Thank you very much. We have Barry doing the other.
okay to have that music in background. I understand. It's important to have it. So please don't worry about it. It's good for our brother to have the music. It's fine. I'll just introduce it a little bit, but it's fine. Yeah. So it's okay with me. And I know Dad will be saying it's fine. So yeah. So that's where we are. We're going to pray and going to pray for the family, going to pray for all of us at this time. Let us pray. God of mercy, Lord of life, you have made us in your image. To reflect your truth and light, we give you thanks for Charles, for the grace and mercy he received from you, and for all that was good in his life, for the memories we treasure today. You promised eternal life to those who believe. Remember for good this your servant Charles. As we also remember him, bring all who rest in Christ into the fullness of your kingdom, where sins have been forgiven and death is no more. You are tender towards your children, and your mercy is over all your works. Heal and heal the memories of heart and failure. Give us the wisdom and the grace to use alike the time that is left to us here on earth, to turn to Christ and to follow his steps in the way that leads to everlasting life. Comfort your people this day, be with them in the days to come, and encourage them anytime they think of their father, their brother, their uncle. May your presence, God, be always with them. And we ask this in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. We join together to say the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. Give us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, power and glory, forever and ever. Before I commend Charles to the mercy of God, there's one song that Mama loves so much, and I'm going to play that music, and then we're going to commend challenge.
Thank you.
Friends, we are coming to very close to the end of our service together here. I just want to say that thank you for being able to use this service. We're normally here at 11 o'clock every Sunday, so I know most of you have never been to this church, so we always here at 11 o'clock every Sunday, and it's an opportunity and privilege for us to take the service for our child. Please stand if you're able to.
Let us commend Charles Afriyie to the mercy of God, our Maker and Redeemer. God, our Creator and Redeemer, by your power, Christ conquered death and entered into glory, confident of his victory, and claiming his promises, we entrust Charles Afriyie to your mercy. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord, who died and is alive, and lives with you now and forever. Amen. The next service is going to happen in the new site. So please be seated as my colleagues, gentlemen, come and take Afriyie out. And then we'll go back to our class. We'll meet at the new site.
I need a piano.
Thank you. Yes.
Is it two of them there? Two Mercedes, isn't it?
There's four in there.
Yeah, but that means this is ours.
Yeah.
Thank you.
God.
Thank you. Thank you.
straight at me.
Thank you.
the king.
So I'm going to offer the next thing.
I think it's right. I think I was the last one.
Great side, please, ladies and gentlemen.
Friends, if you could draw close up, please, if you can. So we don't have the mic here, and with all this mask now,
we can hear you.
You can hear me. Thank you. I appreciate it. I'm going to invite Barry before we proceed. We missed the eulogy, and I think this is the best place where Barry could lead that for us. When we are all here together. After that, I'm going to bless this house for Charles, and then we'll proceed from there. Barry, please.
I would like to give thanks for the life of the man I am proud to be able to call my father, the unique, extraordinary, and irreplaceable Charles Kudjo Afriyie, effectively known as Charlie. Dad was born in Ghana on the 20th of April, 1962. He had many siblings, such as Auntie Nana, Uncle George, and others. Dad left Ghana for England in pursuit of a career enhancement. It is here he met his lovely Mrs. Lisa Henderson. Mom and Dad have been together for 31 years, a bond developed that is irreplaceable. He is survived by 8 children and 6 grandchildren he loved dearly. Dad stayed in England and has been blessed with many memories, hard work, determination from being a minicab driver, evolving to be a successful business owner, property management, and a real inspiration to the local community. My father was a vibrant force, energy in my life, and the life of so many others. My lasting memories of him will always be a hardworking man who cherished and loved his family dearly. A special dad is hard to find. This is going to be a poem that I like to share with you. A special dad is hard to find. You, Dad, I keep you in my mind. I wish you could stay forever, but I'll never forget you, oh, not ever. If dreams were dreams and dreams came through, I wouldn't be here, I'd be with you. Distance is one thing that keeps us apart, but Dad, you will always remain in my heart. A special smile, a special face, a special someone I can't replace. I love you, and Dad, and I always will. You fill a space that never ever will be replaced. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Barry. I'm going to bless the grave. Just before we bless the grave, I just want to say it's different funerals in these circumstances, because normally we have lots of people singing when we are returning the soil, we're backfilling, but now we'll be having the music from your speaker. So if this is different. In the church, many people will be singing or speaking, but because of the regulations, that's why you are seeing we are having a different way of a funeral. Let us bless the grave. O God, whose Son, Jesus Christ, was raised in a tomb, we bless, we pray this grave as the place where the body of Charles, your servant, may rest in peace through your Son, who is the resurrection and the life, who died and is alive and reigns with you now and forever. Amen.
Amen.
Gentlemen. Gentlemen.
So we are going to lower Charles, and then we proceed to the next committal service. Yeah.
Thank you.
Have but a short life. Like a flower, we blossom and then we wither. Like a shadow, we flee and never stay. In the midst of life, we are in death. To whom can we turn for help? But to you, O Lord, who are just, angered by our sins. Yet, Lord God, host, most holy, Lord most mighty, O holy and most merciful Savior. Deliver us from the bitter pain of eternal death. Lord, you know the secret of our hearts. Hear our prayer. O God most mighty, spare us, most worthy judge eternal. At our last hour, let us not fall from you, O holy and merciful Savior. My dear brothers and sisters, we have entrusted our brother Charles Afriyie to God's mercy, and we now commit his body to the ground. Earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust. Ensure a certain hope of resurrection of eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ, who will transform our frail bodies that we may be confounded to his glorious body, who died, was buried, and rose again for us. To him be the glory forever. Amen.
Amen.
You'll be given an opportunity to pay your tribute. And I would encourage people to keep distance, please. Be, yeah.
Charles.
Charlie, rest in peace in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
So check your volume.
Is your volume okay?
Still as
this pandemic is crippling the family a bit, because most people don't know that you can write off.
In fact, some of the guys are just not right here. done. Charlie, look what you do.
Thank you. good to come.
Yeah.
Sisters, we will come to the end of our service, and may I give you a blessing. May God give you his comfort and his peace, his light and his joy in this world and the next. And the blessings of God Almighty, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and may with you always. Amen. 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 Charles, rest in peace, arise in glory.
Amen. This pandemic is crippling families with debt because most people don't know that you can write off any unsecured debts that you can't afford.
Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, fortress of glory divine. Oh, salvation, mercy of God. Born of His Spirit.
Family will come and place the flowers at some point, but we just want to say that our service is ended.
Thank
go
you.
In peace of Christ.
Thank you.
God bless you.
God bless you.
Thank you.
Do not make another debt repayment until you have watched this. Most people don't know.
Yes, 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 very good. Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Of my way, baby, center on your grace.
Richard, where?
I'm not going to come. I said, it's here.